the auditorium with more action.
Get our crew. There you see our cue. There you see Wahoo McDaniel with the headdress coming up and into the ring. All pro in football. Let's go to Gene Okerlund.
All right, fans, more exciting action continuing here tonight. The largest wrestling event held indoors in North America. One fall, 20-minute bout. First of all, in the corner to my right, from Cocoa Beach, Florida, he weighs 256 pounds, Dizzy Ed Boulder. Dizzy Ed Boulder. In the corner to my immediate left, two-time All-American at the University of Oklahoma, 9 years in the National Football League, from Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, at 261 pounds, one of the great Indian wrestlers of all time, ladies and gentlemen, Wahoo McDaniel. Wahoo McDaniel. Referee Steve Olsonowski, one fall, 20-minute time limit.
Wahoo McDaniel, Dizzy Ed Boulder. The action continues here at the Civic Center on Super Sunday. We hope you're enjoying it, whether you're here at the Civic Center or you're a member of the thousands in the closed circuit television audience at the St. Paul Auditorium. I'm Rod Trongard, along with Gene Okerlund. You see in the ring now, referee Steve Olsonowski giving the preliminaries to Boulder, who offers a handshake, and Wahoo McDaniel, and we are ready. One fall, 20 minutes. Boulder breaks cleanly. We can expect that to change, however, as this wears on. He muscles McDaniel across the ring. Breaks cleanly again. Pleased to have joining me for commentary. He has had a little bit of time to recover from his grueling match with John Golden Greek Tolis. We talk about Jerry the King Lawler. Congratulations on an excellent victory, Jerry. This one, it's getting rougher as the time goes on for sure. Yours was of that same variety. We have a microphone problem with Jerry. We will be getting it hooked up here momentarily, and you'll be hearing the comment of Jerry King Lawler. As you see, a test of strength right now in the ring. Wahoo McDaniel locking up with Dizzy Ed Boulder. McDaniel turning it around, turning it into an arm lock and a takedown with Dizzy Ed Boulder on the bottom. Wahoo doesn't stand still for any shenanigans, and he lets his opponent know that in no uncertain terms with his own moves and maneuvers. You saw him power his boot across the forehead of Dizzy Ed Boulder. We're working on our second microphone to see if we can get it hooked up, and you can be hearing the comments of Jerry Lawler. I have a headset on here, and let's see, maybe we can turn it around in some way where we can work off of it. And until they get the problem rectified, Jerry and I can work off the same microphone. Okay, Jerry.
Thank you, Rod. Sorry about causing all this problem. I just want to come out here and say, you know, what a pleasure it is to be on this card. It is truly, as you said, a Super Sunday. The matches so far have been action-packed. And like you said also, the best is yet to come. This match right now is really heating up. And I felt real fortunate to get a win over John, the Golden Greek Tolis. There at one point I thought there was going to be a disqualification in the match there, as Tolis hit me with an uppercut, and my momentum carried me over the top rope and out of the ring. But Of course, you know, I felt fortunate that the referee didn't ring the bell because it wasn't deliberate on Tolis's part. Of, you know, if you're going to throw a man over the top rope, that is an automatic disqualification. But I felt fortunate that the referee didn't ring the bell because it was my own momentum that carried me over, and he just threw the uppercut and knocked me over. That enabled me to get a pin on the man, and I was feel real fortunate to get that.
You didn't want to win the match in that particular manner. There are other ways that you are capable of winning a match, but the hold which you used to win it, the pile driver, has got to be one of the most devastating holds in professional wrestling. It can put a man out of action permanently.
Well, you know, there's no doubt about it. I feel like I have it down to perfection, you know, that's why I use it whenever I feel I have my opponent softened up and try to get the pin on him. I go for that pile driver. It's what I put Andy Kaufman in the hospital with for 5 days, and it's what I try to win most of my matches with.
Looks like Wahoo McDaniel is in a bit of a troubled spot or problem area right now with Dizzy Ed Boulder having that leg across his throat. But Wahoo, despite having been around the game of professional wrestling for quite some time and 9 years in professional football, is still one of the most resilient wrestlers that are in the game, and I certainly look for him to be coming back from this situation that he's in right now.
Well, absolutely. They don't come any tougher than Wahoo McDaniel, and they don't come any more ring-wise than Wahoo. This Dizzy Ed Boulder, as you can see, the massive upper body on this kid. He's young, he's brash, he's cocky, and he's got a fantastic amount of strength, as you can see there. He turned Wahoo completely upside down with that, and the kid is, you know, he's arrogant and he's a good athlete, there's no doubt about it, but there is no substitute for experience, and Wahoo has that, plus all the strength and ability to back it up, and you can look for Wahoo to get out of this trouble any minute now.
Talking about strength and experience, strength is going to be on certainly the side of the likes of Jerry Blackwell and Adnan L. Casey in the match that they go against Mad Dog Vachon and Vern Gagne, but the experience is with Gagne and Vachon, and that, I guess, is going to have to be the telltale thing of it all if indeed Gagne and Vachon are going to win here later tonight.
Well, that's true. That's what the people are here to see. We're looking forward to that match especially. You know, it'll be great to see somebody put the brakes on this Blackwell and Al Casey because, you know, they've been running roughshod over just about everybody in this area. And it may just take the likes of Vern Gagne and Mad Dog to put an end to these two guys.
Well, Wahoo has gone to work now on the golden, or beg your pardon, Dizzy Ed Boulder. That souffle that you saw here just a moment ago, but Boulder is far from finished, that's for sure.
Well, this kid, like I said, you know, he's got tremendous upper body strength, and I'm sure you can tell by looking at a guy like that, he spends hours upon hours in a gym working out. And not only building up his strength, but he's building up his stamina. It's going to take a lot to slow this kid down. It's going to take a lot to take the drive out of a kid like this. And Wahoo's going to have to pull out all the stops, give it everything he's got if he's going to take the fall on this kid.
These two guys are really punishing each other right now.
Well, I know. You know, I've been on the receiving end of some of Wahoo's chops in the past, and I know what those things are like. Now, if you want something to take the drive out of you, those chops will do it. I can assure you.
The tomahawk, of course, a weapon that Wahoo uses frequently. We haven't seen it yet. There he uses the turnbuckle to drive Dizzy Ed Boulder, and he goes on the other side of the ring to do it. And, of course, the crowd is on the side of Wahoo McDaniel, and here he goes one more time.
Well, you know, there's no way to determine just exactly what that crowd support means to an athlete when he's in that ring, not only to a professional wrestler, but any professional athlete, the football player, baseball player, whatever. When you know that you're out there and when you're in a bad situation and you hear that crowd going for you, you know that you're not, you got to reach back and get that little something extra, not only for yourself, but for all of those people that have, you know, that have been behind you all this way. And that's exactly what Wahoo's doing now, and those people appreciate it, and he's going to do it for them if it can be done.
You've seen the tomahawk in action, and you've got a pin here as Wahoo McDaniel covers Dizzy Ed Boulder, and we will see it in slow motion. Jerry the King Lawler, yours truly, and all of you, let's take a look at it again and see exactly what Wahoo McDaniel did. He whips him in, and there, well, you call it the tomahawk, or you can call it a judo chop and an elbow smash. I think that's the thing that did it right there more than anything, the elbow smash.
When he comes down with that elbow and forearm and chop, from that standing position, it's all over.
You saw Dizzy Ed Boulder recover, but...